a steak, and that steak acts as the fix for the 4x4. So it's still a steak.
This is what we're looking for. His hair is getting kind of brown.
Thank you.
Okay, so when you make Rice Krispie treats, the next step is to spread them in a pan, let them cool, and to cut them up. However, once I get to this step, this is when I start eating Rice Krispie treats. So I don't worry about messing up another pan. It's straight from the bowl. I usually make them in the microwave, but this technique required the stove. I make them in a bowl, and then I just taste it. So I'm going to taste it like that. I did learn something when I was looking at recipes for this, or when I was looking up ideas for this, is that when you put them in the pan, you shouldn't press them down too much, because it'll make them harder and more condensed and harder to eat. So it's better just to kind of like lay them there and then just kind of smooth them out, but not to push down too hard. I didn't know, because again, once I get it here, it goes in here. So we're going to taste test browned butter Rice Krispie treats. And I did use margarine because I didn't have enough butter. I would prefer butter, but here we go. It actually is a noticeable difference in the flavor. It's got kind of almost like a nutty flavor to it. What kind of caramelish, almost like a caramel and a slight hint of like a nutty flavor to it from browning the butter. So won't cost you any more to make your Rice Krispie treats a little unique and stand out. So try it.